Many a time we are limited by the things we see. What you can see matters as it affects your overall perspective of life. How you think, your expectations, your response and your attitude to circumstances around you. As believers, the Bible tells us that we do not work by sight but by faith. This is because the things we can see with our physical eyes are limited. But when you look through the eyes of faith, all things are possible. So, through which lens do you view the world, and specifically your life? Are you limited to the things you can see, or to things that you have heard people say? Whose report do you believe? God's or man? A natural man without Christ will be guided by principles that apply to this world. So, it is normal for him to toil before he can succeed, and his progress in life will be subject and at the mercy of fellow men, who can be unpredictable and sometimes wicked. We, on the other hand, operate on a supernatural level where we call things forth, and so we are not bounded or limited by the things we see. Situations may arise and try to shake our faith, but we know of our advantage in Christ. Instead of laboring to get things, we can subscribe to God's favor upon our lives, to open doors that have previously been closed. In essence, we are not bounded by the principles of this world or restricted to its resources. Just take a careful look at the promises of God concerning your life. There are so many of them. First, your future is guaranteed in Christ because God has great plans for you. Jeremiah 29, verse 11 says, "For I know the thoughts and plans that I have for you, says the Lord, thoughts and plans for welfare and peace and not for evil, to give you hope in your outcome, even more than you think of yourself." God thinks of you, and because of the love he has towards mankind, he is willing to do everything to ensure that we live in abundance, wealth, and health. Just think about it. If he did not withhold his only begotten Son from us, but gave him up so that we will be reconciled with him, how much more will he give us all things? Doors signify access, and you need some doors to be open before you can reach or get to certain places in life. Sometimes God himself shuts the door either because it is not the time or because disaster is waiting on the other end. Either way, you can be sure that whatever God does is for your good because he has your best interest at heart. Yet some other doors require persistence and diligence before they will be opened to you. So, you just have to keep knocking tirelessly until it opens up for you. Many times, we either do not have the strength or patience to wait for what God is doing, and so we settle for less. We see things through our physical eyes, make calculations in our hearts, follow the logical reasoning of men, and choose to believe their reports, which are why many remain at the same level in life, even though God has a higher purpose for them. Sometimes the road through which God will take you might look rough and difficult, but you have to focus on what is before you and not what surrounds you. Be like Jesus. Hebrews 12 verse 2 says, "Looking away from all that will distract to Jesus, who is the leader and the source of our faith, giving the first incentive for our belief and is also its finisher, bringing it to maturity and perfection. He, for the joy of obtaining the prize that was set before him, endured the cross, despising and ignoring the shame, and is now seated at the right hand of the throne of God." If you want to get the prize, you must be able to pay the price. There is a bigger door that you could ever imagine opening up to you now. But how do you access it? See Revelation 3 verse 8. I know your record of works and what you are doing. See, I have set before you a door wide open which no one can shut. I know that you have but little power, and yet you have kept my word and guarded my message and have not renounced or denied my name. God has opened a door before you which no man can shut. If you must access this door, let us look at a few things you should do. First, you should have faith in God. Not just the kind of faith you proclaim with your mouth, but have no belief. Your faith in God is the evidence that you believe that you will have whatever you think. And faith comes by hearing the word of God. How much of His word do you have inside you? How much of His promises for your life do you believe? If you do not know God's word, then there is no basis for your faith. You are limited by what you know, and ignorance can rid you of your inheritance. If you do not know your father is wealthy, do you make demands on his wealth? No, because you do not know. So you must grow in the knowledge of God's word first and foremost. Read, study, and meditate on it over and over again. Keep listening to it, because what you hear constantly has a way of shaping your life. The things you hear constantly soon become your reality. The more you hear it, the more it becomes a part of you, making your faith to grow. That is the more reason the Bible says faith comes by hearing and hearing the word of God. Now that you know those promises, you can go ahead and declare them in faith. Trust in the ability and the faithfulness of God to bring them to pass. Faith grants you access and makes you see beyond the natural realm. Faith is a recognized currency in heaven. Without faith, you cannot please God and therefore cannot have access to the things He has made available for you. Hebrews 11 verse 6 says, "But without faith it is impossible to please and to be satisfactory to Him. For whoever would come near to God must necessarily believe that God exists and that He is the rewarder of those who earnestly and diligently seek Him out." The next thing to do is contend for it. The fact that God has opened a door for you does not necessarily mean that you will have automatic access to it. Why? 1 Corinthians 16 verse 9 says, "For a wide door of opportunity for effectual service has opened to me. There a great and promising one. And there are many adversaries." Yes, there are many adversaries out there that are set against your success and progress. The devil is the one leading them, and his work in a man's life is to steal, kill, and destroy. Remember the story of Esther. That was one phenomenal transformation of a lady from a slave in a strange land to becoming a queen. That's one big, unimaginable door that God opened for her, but the devil did not rest even after she became queen. The devil sought the means to wipe her entire tribe and nation through Haman. What did Esther do at this point, where her life and that of her people was threatened? She called for a fast and prayed earnestly before appearing before the king. In response, God opened another door of favor for her, and when she appeared before the king without prior notice, her life was spared. And that was not the only thing. She was able to invite the king and present her request before him, thereby sparing her life and that of her people. Have it in mind that great things require great sacrifices. Your faith and convictions will be tested. When we ask God for certain things, He does not give them to us directly. Rather, He allows us to access those things. Joseph went from being a slave to a prisoner, and all through he was tested. But because he could persevere and had the fear of God in him, he was able to come out victorious. Daniel was tested with the den of lions, and his friends had to go through the fiery furnace. One thing that was common with them was that they held fast to their convictions and refused to compromise. As a result, they were all promoted to greater positions. You might be going through something similar and are tempted to bend, compromise, or give in. Do not, because that is the path to your greatness. The road may be rough, but it will lead you to a glorious path, greater than one you could have imagined. Just keep holding on and refuse to be cowed by situations around you. You are well on your way to success, and great things await you. Finally, a thankful heart opens the door for God to perform His miracles. Do not be anxious about anything. Philippians 4 verse 6 says, "Do not fret or have any anxiety about anything, but in every circumstance and in everything, by prayer and petition, definite requests, with thanksgiving, continue to make your wants known to God." While you pray and put your faith in God, remain thankful and optimistic. See those doors being opened for you, and they will come to reality. You will begin to experience miracles in your life.